Most of us know that dinosaurs roamed the planet for an impressive amount of time, going back almost 250 million years ago. And this gigantic chunk of world history has been categorized into three main periods: the Triassic, the Jurassic, and the Cretaceous. Way before the likes of the T-Rex and other recognizable big names, the world was a very different place. Dinosaurs were just beginning their reign, with mostly smaller, lightweight herbivores roaming around. This was, of course, around 250 million years ago, the beginning of the Triassic period. These early dinosaurs were nothing like the dominating predators we now know of. Instead, these creatures were smaller scaled. Take the Bryolestes schultzi, for example. This early sauropodomorph only weighed around 34 pounds, a far cry of what was to come. These primitive dinosaurs shared their environment with early reptiles like the Rhinoceros. Small and beaked, they would have been quite common in most areas across the continent of Pangaea. For millions of years, most creatures were either small reptiles or plant-eating herbivores, but that all changed around 233 million years ago. This is the Gnathovorax, possibly the first true carnivorous dinosaur to walk the planet. It holds the record for the oldest known meat-eating dinosaur we've ever discovered, beating the previous record by more than 30 million years. And for its time, Gnathovorax was a giant. At up to 10 feet long and weighing 1,100 pounds, it dwarfed most of its early dinosaurian relatives. The only known dinosaurs that date back this far were less than twice the size, barely reaching 5 feet in length. These include the plant-eating sauropod Bryolestes schultzi, found at a nearby fossil site. Unlike most early dinosaur discoveries, which are often found in fragmented pieces, Gnathovorax's fossils have been surprisingly well preserved, with an almost complete skeleton intact. These fossils are so well preserved, in fact, scientists have been able to reconstruct the shape of its brain for CT scans, revealing crucial details about its sensory abilities. According to Dr. Muller, a biologist from Federal University of Santa Maria who led the study, the effort revealed features shared with other predators, including well-developed areas related to visual coordination and balance. This combination of assets indicated that this new dinosaur was an active predator of its time. Gnathovorax is classified as a hererosaurid, with the hererosauridae being one of the oldest known families of predatory dinosaurs known to have roamed what we now know as modern-day Argentina and Brazil. While it was still primitive compared to later theropods, Gnathovorax had the traits of a top predator. This was its razor-sharp teeth, strong legs, and a keen eyesight, and made it a deadly hunter in the world still dominated by creatures smaller or more primitive than itself. The Gnathovorax had a very impressive reign, with it only eventually dying out about 30 million years later. The Gnathovorax was able to maintain its position in the pecking order and continue to thrive for tens of millions of years, which is no small feat. Now, the reason for its extinction is still up for debate. One of the leading theories is that it likely went extinct due to environmental conditions. By the time Gnathovorax numbers began to seriously decrease, they were now living in the late Triassic period. There may have been potential climate shifts, fluctuations in food availability, and not forgetting the competition of newly evolving predators. The Gnathovorax wasn't the big dog anymore. But the Gnathovorax earned its name in the history books, paving the way for giants like an Allosaurus, Spinosaurus, or T-Rex. It may have not been the biggest or most famous, but in the story of dinosaur evolution, Gnathovorax holds a very special title: the world's first carnivorous dinosaur.